Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to English session. So we were in the lesson number 6, Poets and Pancakes, which is written by Ashoka Mitra. So we have seen in last class that Shibu could always be found with the boss, but officially he worked under the story department. The department consists of poets, writers, and strangely a lawyer. He was often referred to as legal advisor, but people used to call him the opposite. This was because once a high-tempered actress starting throwing tantrums on set, leaving everyone stunned, while he went and secretly switched on the recording equipment. He played it when the actress paused for breath, leaving her shocked. There was nothing offensive against the producer, but her problematic tone, volume, and tantrum sent her into a trauma which was hard for her to recover from. It marked the end of her short but brilliant acting career, and the legal advisor was responsible for it somehow. So we will begin with a new paragraph today. The paragraph begins in this way. While every other member of the department wore a kind of uniform khadi dhoti with a slightly oversized and clumsily tailored with white khadi shirt, the legal advisor wore pants and a tie and sometimes a coat that looked like a coat of mail. Often he looked alone and helpless, a man of cold logic in a crowd of dreamers, a neutral man in an assembly of Gandhiites and Khadites. Like so many of those who were close to the boss, he was allowed to produce a film and threw a lot of raw stock and pancake were used on it. Not much came out of the film. Then one day that boss closed down the story department, and this was perhaps the only instance in all human history where a lawyer lost his job because the poets were asked to go home. The khadi means an Indian homespun cotton cloth. As you all know, dhoti means a garment worn by male Hindus consisting of a piece of material tied around the waist and extended to cover most of the legs. Coat of mail here means a protective garment made of linked metal rings or mail or of overlapping metal piece plates. Cold logic means a logic that fails to consider human factors such as culture, language, social dynamics, personality and emotion. So in this paragraph, it explains in this way that the lawyer wore unique clothes different from the usual uniform that consisted of a dhoti made of khadi fabric and a slightly oversized khadi shirt. He was generally seen wearing pants, tie and sometimes a coat which was like an armor. He was a neutral man with logic which did not value human feelings and was usually seen helpless in a world full of literary enthusiasts. He, narrator, called him neutral man in the assembly of Gandhiites or the Khadites because he was different from the rest of them. He was very close to the boss and just as the trend goes, he was too allowed allowed to produce his own film, which could not do very well. A lot of makeup products and pancakes stash were used in the process. Eventually, the boss shut down the story department. The narrator expressed it in a only instance in human history where a lawyer lost his job because of the poets were asked to go home. As the story department were closed, the poets were rendered worthless along with the lawyer. Next paragraph. Gemini Studios were the favorite haunt of poets like S.G.S. Yogiyar, Sangu Subramanian, Krishna Shastri, and Harindranath Chattopadhyay, Chattopadhyay, it had an excellent mess which supplied good coffee at all times of the day and for most part of all the night. Those were the days when conqueror's rule meant provision and meeting over a cup of coffee was rather satisfying entertainment. Barring the office boys and a couple of clerks, everybody else at the studios radiated leisure and a precursor for poetry. Most of them wore khadi and worshipped Gandhiji, but beyond that, they had not the faintest appreciation for political thought of any kind. Naturally, they were all averse to the term. Communism, a communist was a godless man. He had no filial or conjugal love. He had no compunction about killing his own parents or children. He was always out to cause spread and unrest, violence among innocent and ignorant people. Such notions, which prevailed everywhere else in South India at that time, also naturally floated about vaguely among the khaki-clad poets of Germany studios. Evidence of which was soon of forthcoming. Here, haunt means frequently visited by. Mess means a building or room providing meals. Provision means the act of providing something. Or leisure means time when one is not working or occupied, free time. Precursive means what? A thing that is required as a prior condition for something else to happen or exist. Averse means what? Having strong dislike or opposition to something. Communism means what? Collectivism and socialism. Or filial means what? Relating to or due from a son or daughter. Conjugal means what? Relating to marriage or the relationship between a married couple. Compunction means reluctance. Vaguely means what? In a way that is uncertain. Forthcoming means about to happen or appear. In this paragraph, it explains that Germany studio was frequently famous poets like S.G.S. Yogiyar, Sangu Subramanian, Krishna Shastri and Harindra Nath Chattopadhyay. The mess at the studio was excellent. It prepared a nice coffee which was available all day long. In those days, conqueror's rule meant restrictions and a cup of coffee with friends was the only source of entertainment. Only the office boys and some clerks at the studio worked. The others enjoyed their free time, which was necessary for creating poetry. Most of the poets wore clothes made of khadi fabric and respected Gandhiji for its prevalence, were not politically inclined. They hated terms like communism because they thought that a communist did not love his family. He did not hesitate in killing them. He was there to create violence among the ignorant and innocent people. Such a thought was prevalent in South India, and the poets were no exceptions to it. The proof of their thought would be shortly. Now, next paragraph. When Frank Buchmann's moral rearmament army, most 200 strong, visited Madras sometime in 1952. They were could not found a warmer host in India than the Germany studios. Someone called the group an international circus. They weren't very good on the trapeze, and their acquaintance with animals was only at the dinner table. But they presented two plays in a most professional manner. there, Jodham Valley and the Forgotten Factor ran several shows in Madras and along with other citizens of the city. Gemini family of 600 saw the plays over and over again. So the message of the plays were usually plain and simple, homilies, but the sets and the costumes were the first rate. Madras and the Tamil drama community were terribly impressed, and for some years almost all. Tamil plays had a scene of sunrise and sunset in the manner of Jodham Valley with a bare stage and a white background curtain and a tune played on the flute. Trapeze horizontal bar hanging with two ropes and free to swing used by acrobats in a circus. Homilies means what? The sermon or lecture. Bare means what? Empty. So in this paragraph it explains that Gemini Studios displayed extreme hospitality when Frank Buchmann's Moral Rearmament Army, consisting of 200 people, came to Madras in 1952. They were referred to as the International Circus, even though they were not very good with the trapeze, and only association they had with animals was at the dinner table. They ate non-vegetarian food, and other than that, they did not interact with animals as they was done in circus. The two plays that were performed with full proficiency and professionalism got a lot of appreciation while they performed it again and again in different parts of Madras. Though the plots and messages were not complex, their sets and costumes were near to perfection, so much so that for many years Tamil plays displayed sunset and sunrise in a way inherited from Jodham Valley. So, the next paragraph. It was some years later that I learned that the MRA kind of counter movement to international communism and the big bosses of Madras like Mr. Vassal simply played into their hands. I'm not sure, however, that this was indeed the case, for the unchangeable aspects of these big bosses and their enterprises remained the same. MRA, international communism or no international communism. The staff of Gemini Studios had a nice time hosting 200 people, all whose and size of at least 20 nationalities. It was such a change from the usual collection of crowd players waiting to be slapped with thick layers of makeup by the office boy in the makeup department. So your counter movement means what? A movement or other action made in opposition to another. Played into their hands to do something that does not realize will hurt oneself and help someone else. Whose means what? Complexion. So in this paragraph, this says that the MRA was supposed to communism, and people like Mr. Watson was suffering at their hands. However, these bosses and their business remained unaffected by such issues. Not only the audience, but also the staff of Gemini Studios had a great time hosting 200 people from over 20 nationalities. It was different from their usual routine of crowd performances, where groups of people would wait to get heaps on makeups on their face by the makeup department. Now moving to the next paragraph. A few months later, telephone lines of the big bosses of Madras burst, and once again we at Gemini Studios cleared a whole shooting stage to welcome another visitor. All they said was that he was a poet from England. the only poet from England the simple Gemini staff knew or heard of were Wordsworth and Tennyson's. The more literate ones knew of Keats, Shelley and Byron, and one or two might have faintly come to know of someone by the name of Eliot. Who was that poet visiting Gemini Studios now? So after a few months, Gemini Studios got yet another chance to welcome a poet from England. People made guesses about who was going to visit this time, because most people knew a few poets like Wordsworth or Tennyson, or the enthusiastic knew about the Keats, Shelley or Byron or even Eliot. They were curious as to who was the one visiting Gemini Studios. Next paragraph. He is not a poet, he is an editor. That's why the boss is giving him a big reception. Vasan was also the editor of the popular Tamil weekly Ananda Viketan. He wasn't the editor of any of the non-names of British publication in Madras. That is, those known at the Gemini Studios, since the top men of the Hindu were taking the initiative. The surmise was that the poet was the editor of a daily, but not from the Manchester Guardian or the London Times. That was all that even most well-informed among us knew. Surmise means what? Guess or suspect. I repeat, surmise means what? Guess or suspect. So in this paragraph, it says that the person about to visit Gemini Studios was not a poet but an editor of a newspaper daily, and thus the boss was planning on giving him a huge welcome. Even Vasan was the editor of a famous Tamil weekly publication titled Anand Viketan. There were many famous publishing houses in Madras that had been set up by the British, which everyone, at least Gemini Studios, knew about. The highest level of managers at the Hindu were involved, which meant that the editor was a prominent personality. The staff at Gemini only knew two newspapers, Manchester Guardian and the Guardian Times. The man was not the editor of either of the two. Next paragraph. At last, around 4 in the afternoon, the poet or the editor arrived. He was a tall man, very English, very serious, and of course very unknown to all of us. Battling with half a dozen pedestal fans on the shooting stage, the boss read out a long speech. It was obvious that he too knew precious little about the poet or the editor. The speech was all in the most general terms, but here and there it was peppered with words like freedom and democracy. Then the poet spoke. He couldn't have addressed a more dazed and silent audience. In no one knew what he was talking about, and his accent defeated any attempt to understand what he was saying. The whole thing lasted about an hour. Then the poet left and we all dispersed in utter bafflement. What are we doing? What is an English poet doing in a film studio which makes Tamil films for the simplest sort of people? People whose lives least afforded them the possibility of cultivating a taste for English poetry. The poet looked very pretty baffled too, for he too must have felt the sheer incongruity of his talk about the thrills and the travels of an English poet. His visit remained an unexplained mystery, bafflement, confusion, bewilderment. So, in this paragraph, it says that the guest finally arrived at a ground 4 in the afternoon. He was tall and he was serious looking British face, obviously, which was unknown to almost all of them. Boss welcomed him with a speech, and the speech was evident of the fact that he knew about him just as a little as they did. The speech was general, but they could not help but hear words like freedom and democracy. Then it was a time for the poet or the editor to enlighten the audience, but unfortunately no one could understand the word which he was saying because of the British accent. Everyone was felt bewildered. The visitors were just as confused. People couldn't understand the reason why a British poet was there at a studio that made Tamil films, and in between people could not afford to develop a taste for the English poetry. His visit was indeed a mystery. Next paragraph. The great prose writers of the world may not admit it, but my convictions grow stronger day after day that prose writing is not and cannot be the true pursuit of genius. It is for the patient, persistent and persevering drudge with the heart so strong that nothing can break it. Rejection slips don't mean a thing to him. He at once sets about making a fresh copy of the long prose piece and sends it on to another editor, enclosing postage for the return of manuscript. It was for such people that Hindu had published a tiny announcement in an insignificant corner of an unimportant page, a short story contest organized by British periodical by the name of The Encounter. Of course, Encounter wasn't a non-commodity among the Gemini literary. I wanted to get an idea of the periodical before I spent a considerable sum in a postage sending a manuscript to England. In those days, the British Council Library had an entrance with no long-winded signboards and the notices to make you feel you were sneaking into a forbidden area. And there were copies of Encounter lying about in various degrees of freshness. Almost untouched by her, a bell ringing in my shrunken heart. It was the poet who had visited the Germany studios. I felt like I had found a long post brother, and I sang as I sealed the envelope and wrote out his address. I felt that he too would be singing the same song at the same time. Long lost brothers of Indian films discover each other by singing the same song in the first reel and in the final reel of the film. Stephen Spenter. So Spenter, that was his name. Spenter means what? That was his name. And the pursuit means what? Hobby or activity. Genius means what? An exceptionally intelligent person. Persevering means what? Continuing in a course of action despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. Drudge means a person made to hard, manual or dull work. Manuscript means what? An author's handwritten or a typed text that has not yet been published. Literary means what? Well-educated people who are interested in literature. Sneaking into means what? Doing something in a very secretive or the sleazy way. Forbidden means what? Not allowed or banned. So in this paragraph, Ashokamitran feels that the writing cannot be performed by the intelligent because it is a task of those who are patient and can do the hard work. A writer should not have any feelings and not be bogged down by rejection and must be able to prepare a healthy prose. Mailed it to the editor along with stamped envelope for return of the manuscript. For such writers, the Hindu had advertised that there was a short story contest organized by British publication titled The Encounter. The writers at Gemini Studio had not heard of the name. Ashoka Mitran wanted to know about it before he decided to spend money on mailing his entry and sending it to England. He visited the British Council library to get information. In those days, the entrance of library was simple, without signboards and notices, and no one felt as they were entering a restricted area. At the library, he saw many copies of The Encounter. The editor's name rang a bell in Ashoka Mitran's heart. He felt that he had found a long, long lost brother and was glad when he mailed his entry for the contest. He thought that he too would sing the same song when he found would get his mail. Editor's name was Stephen Spencer. And years later, when I was out of Gemini Studios and I had much time but not much money, anything at a reduced piece attracted my attention. On the footpath in front of the Madras Mount Road post office, there was a pile of brand new books for 50 paise each. Actually, they were copies of same book, an elegant paperback, of American origin. Special low price student edition in connection with the 50th anniversary of the Russian Revolution. I paid 50 paise and picked up a copy of the book, God That Failed. Six eminent men of letters in six separate essays described their journey into communism and their disillusioned return. Andre Gide, Richard Wright, Gesenio Ceylon, Arthur Koester, Louis Fisher and Stephen Spencer. Stephen Spencer, suddenly the book assumed tremendous significance. Stephen Spender, the poet who had visited Gemini Studios, in a moment I felt a dark chamber of my mind lit up by a hazy illumination. The reaction to Stephen Spender at Gemini Studio was no longer a mystery. A boss of the Gemini Studios may not have much to do with the Spender poetry, but not with the God That Failed. Here, Stephen Spender, an English poet essayist who concentrated on themes of social injustice and class struggle, and Andre Gide is a French writer, humanist, moralist, received the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1947. Richard Wright, an American writer known for his novel Native Son and his autobiography Black Boy. Ignazio Ceylon is an Italian writer who was the founder member of the Italian Communist Party in 1921 and is also known for the book The God That Failed, authored by him. Arthur Koester, a Hungarian poet, British novelist, known for his novel Darkness at Noon. Louis Fisher, a well-known American journalist and writer of Mahatma Gandhi's biography, entitled as we have learned in the Indigo chapter about the Louis Fisher and the life of Mahatma Gandhi. The Oscar winning film Gandhi is based on this biographical account. So what happened in this paragraph? After many years, when the writer felt Gemini Studios, he had plenty of free time but not much money, so he discounted goods on sale attracted him. Once he came across books being sold on the footpath outside the post office located on the Madras Mount Road, they were priced at 50 paise each. They were termed as the student edition, and they were offered at a special low price because they were celebrating the 50th anniversary of the Russian Revolution. They paid 50 paisa and took a book of the copy of the book titled The God That Failed. It had six essays by six famous men who wrote about communism. The writers were Andre Gide, Richard Wright, Ingazino Ceylon, Arthur Koestler, Louis Fisher, and the Stephen Spencer. As the writers read Stephen's name, the book became important for him because he had visited the Gemini studio and he was reminded of him, and the name sounded familiar. Ashoka Mitran thought that the boss at Gemini Studios may not be concerned with Spencer's poetry. Students, this was the end of this lesson, but this is a little bit complicated lesson. So in the next video, I will again do the recap of the summary and I will explain you in a more simplicity way. So until the next video, you try to read the lessons and try to watch this video, then you will able to understand the lesson thoroughly. Until the next class, keep reading, keep watching. Bye from me.